Sally from Switzerland with another live video. And today probably the audio is a little bit different, and also the lighting and everything. That's because we just moved, and that's also why you have seen mainly pre-recorded stuff in the channel the last couple of weeks. But now we're gonna take a look at a cool little unboxing. I have a couple of knives lined up to do some unboxing that I received over this moving period, and they're all customs, and I haven't shown them really off on the channel, and you are in for a treat. This is going to be the first of four unboxings and the first impressions I'm going to do of newer custom knives in my collection. So the knife we're going to take a look at today is in this pretty standard leather case. It's a custom knife out of France from a French knife maker that has a very Italian name. It's from Guy Paghetti. You have seen one of his knives in my Borrowed Blades episodes, and this now is actually mine. This is his Pebble Creek model, which is slightly different than the one that I have reviewed in the, or overviewed in the Borrowed Blade series that was loaned to me by Francois from Belgium. And this is my own Guy Paghetti Pebble Creek, a very, very gorgeous knife. Front flipper, no clip. So it's an overall clipless design. It has gorgeous Arizona ironwood handle scales, a D2 blade with this darker stonewash finish on it, nice full-length wedge, comes down to a super, super thin edge, as you can see right here. It's a liner lock, it runs on bearings, and is very, very smooth. It has a good run of very fine and aggressive jimping, good overall size, of course, very, very good ergonomics. You also have a forward finger trowel that you can use on this knife, a lot of belly there, and just an absolutely gorgeous piece here. You can also see that he has done some gorgeous details here. You can see you have a carbon fiber liner underneath the wood, because you know wood can actually warp a little bit, and to ease that problem, he put in this gorgeous carbon fiber liner as well as a carbon fiber backspacer. And here we have the standoff in the back, everything nice and chamfered, really, really well done. Of course, you have his nice caveman style marking on the blade, stands for Guy Paghetti, and just an overall very, very good looking knife. Size wise, a little bit on the larger end of the things that I like to carry, and he does make knives that have clips. These are mil larger type clips. If I could get my hands on one of those, I probably would swap it out for a clipped model, because as it is, it's certainly nice to carry in a leather pouch or something like that, but you certainly miss a little bit the clip or the convenience of a clip when you're carrying a knife day to day. But it's certainly an absolutely gorgeous collection piece. Certainly it's not going to be a knife that I would use for some harder use tasks. For that I have other knives in my rather large collection, but this knife right here is going to stay here until I find a Guy Paghetti that suits my overall preferences a little bit better. I would love to see a satin kind of blade, but he really likes to do these darker acid stonewash finishes on the blades. Of course, this is going to be very easy if you're actually going to use the knife, because it's going to hide wear and everything much easier than a hand-rubbed satin blade. But it certainly would look a little bit classier if you had a very shiny kind of reflective blade on there. I really love how he has done the screws here. These are blackened screws, they are completely flush to the touch here with the scales. You have a good chunk of Arizona ironwood that has a lot of chatoyance to it. Really, really gorgeous wood, and everything is so nicely chamfered and mated together. You can see that these three materials that make the liner and the scales, they have absolutely no seam. They are so nicely integrated. You have no milling on the inside, so it's not a heavy knife, because you have pretty lightweight overall materials with the carbon fiber liners, the Arizona ironwood scales, and the titanium liners there. So overall, pretty nice and lightweight, good in hand. The only sharp point that I would like to see changed is the end right here. You can see these two little corners here are not really chamfered. The insides of the liners have a slight chamfer on it, so they are not sharp or have any problem. You can also see the slight chamfer on the liner there. So that's all good, but if you grip it the wrong way, you can feel this corner right here sometimes in the hand. Let's do a short size comparison. Here you can see the Pebble Creek, and we have our standard Sugarloaf sandwich. We have the Neon Zero at the bottom, which is pretty close in overall size, but much less broad. And then we have the F95NL. These unboxings will be short little show and tell videos. I'm not going to go into much detail. Later on, if I got the time, I will do individual reviews of the knives and the makers and show you some other things that they have done. But now I just don't have the time to go into that, but I want to show off the knife itself. If you follow my Instagram, you have seen pictures of this and the other custom knives I'm going to show you in the next couple of weeks already, and I would highly recommend you to join me on Instagram and also check out my Patreon if you want to support the channel. But here you can get a pretty good feel of the size of this Pebble Creek model by Guy Poggetti. If you take a look at the thickness, you can see that you get a very nice and fine tip and also a really nice and fine cutting edge comparable to this Shiro here. Of course, D2 is not my favorite steel, especially on a custom knife. I would like to have something a little bit more stainless just for the sake of longevity. But he mostly works with D2. In newer knives, he has moved up to other steels as well. But for a little bit older work, he works mainly in D2, and it certainly is very, very sharp and works really great. So in the hands of a master, I think D2 can be a very good overall steel, but you just have to keep it slightly oiled when in storage. Action wise, you can see free falling blade, great detent for the front flipper deployment. You can also do the two-handed deployment method, of course, but very, very nice and smooth, and just a really, really gorgeous and unique overall design. Love how it looks when it's open, like a little stout fixed blade. Love the overall swedge. Quite a bit of a different blade shape compared to the one I showed in the Borrowed Blade series. I will link that at the end of the video so you can check that out as well. That one had a lightning strike carbon fiber scale, pretty much same blade finish though. So absolutely gorgeous knife, the Guy Poggetti Pebble Creek in Arizona Ironwood carbon fiber backspacer and D2 blade. If you want to know anything about the maker or the knife, please let me know in the comment section below. And as I said before, follow me on Instagram and here on YouTube, and check out my Patreon if you like what I'm doing here and you want to support the channel. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.